Well, shalom, shalom. I'm Barbara, and I'm always short and sweet. And this will be just a little short introduction of Revelation 17:6. I saw the woman, the harlot, drink and be drunk with the blood of the saints and the martyrs of Yeshua. Well, did you know that Pope John Paul II apologized for shedding the blood of the saints? And in this apology, he apologized for 100 actions of the Catholic Church, including the Inquisition, the Muslims killed by the Crusaders, the Jews, Galileo, and women, the Catholic involvement in African slave trade, burnings at the stake, religious war, the Protestant Reformation, and the execution of John Huss, but many more. There are 100 listed, and I will leave all these links below. So what was the Inquisition? Well, it was a group of institutions within the Catholic Church whose aim was to get rid of any heretics, people that went against their beliefs and the church's rule and the Pope's authority. And there was a Spanish Inquisition against the Jews, and they were faced with a choice of baptism or death into the Roman Catholic Church, and they were told they had to give up all their Jewish beliefs. Well, can the persecution of the Catholic Church of 18 and a half centuries be reversed? And here's more about the Jews' persecution. I know you've all heard about the Holocaust. Well, this one has gone on for over 18 centuries, and the Catholic Church apologized for what they've done to the Jews and for their part in the Holocaust. And I hope you'll pause the screen and read all these quotes. Well, what were the Crusades? The Crusades, well, they were a series of religious wars by the Latin Church, the Roman Church there in the Holy Land against the Muslims. And so they were forcing their beliefs and murdering and killing anyone that was a heretic that went against Rome. Well, the Pope also apologized for the burnings at the stake. And according to ancient reports, Roman authorities executed many of Christian martyrs by burning. John Huss, that was in the apology. Apology for burning John Huss at the stake. And this is really awful what they did. They stripped him naked, they put a paper gown on him, and they covered him with wax and poured lard and all these things for liquid fire to burn the heretic. Well, what was the Protestant Reformation? I hope that you will study the Protestant Reformation and realize what it was all about. And it was about challenging the Catholic Church and the Pope's authority. And the main objector that started it was Martin Luther. And he posted his 95 theses against the indulgences that had people paying for forgiveness, paying to keep out of purgatory. And he also found out the Bible said we're saved by faith and not by works. And the Catholic Church tried to get him to renounce everything, and they burned all the material they could find of his, and they excommunicated him for his beliefs and for denouncing the Catholic Church. Well, Romanism is now regarded by Protestants with far greater favor than in former years. And the time was when Protestants placed a high value upon liberty of conscience, which had been so dearly purchased. In fact, that's why we came over to America. Many of them that came over, the Quakers and the Puritans and the Christians, came over to have religious freedom. While this liberty of conscience was purchased by persecution, imprisonment, slavery, burnings, torture, and death, very high price is paid for our liberty. Well, the proudest boast of the Roman Catholic Church is that she never changes. Semper Eadem. What does Semper Eadem mean? Always the same. Certainly, Semper Eadem had always been a proud Catholic boast. And let it be remembered, it is the boast of Rome that she never changes. I hope you'll go look at these links. I recommend this book in the links for the Great Controversy. This author goes through all the persecution by the Roman Church and the Protestant Reformation, and I highly recommend it. So Revelation 17:6 says, "And I saw the woman drunken with the blood of the saints and with the blood of the martyrs of Yeshua." So please like if this is a blessing to you and share it with your friends. I hope you look for the links below and study all this out for yourself. There's a lot of information. Revelation 18:4 says, "And I heard another voice from heaven saying, Come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers in her sins and receive not of her plagues." Remember, I'm short and sweet. I'll be back next time, Yah willing. Thank you for being here and for listening, and I appreciate you.